So good evening, everybody. So I welcome everybody for this lab session. That is, the course name is Advanced Java Laboratory. So today we will discuss the fourth program in this session. Right? What is this fourth program? Write a Java servlet program using cookies to remember user preferences. Okay. So all of you look at this particular diagram. See. See here, this is client and this is server. The client is going to communicate with the server, right? So here, client is going to send a request to the server. The server will process that request, right? And send back the response to the client, okay? See what happens, so during this communication, right? No information is being stored here. Right, so if n number of request is being sent by the client end, so the server will receive the request and process the request, right? So during each request, the server will treat the client as a new client, right? Now here, what is this cookie concept demonstrate that? See here, that information, see, the main aim here, we have to store that information, right? Why? Because, see, when the client communicates with the server should not treat him as a new user for each request, right? For this, we are going to use one technique called as a cookie, right? See, what is this cookie concept demonstrate then? See, during the multiple request from the client, right, the information has to be stored. Now what happens here, see here, the request will be sent to the server, right? When sending the response to the client, the server will add one cookie, right? So that will be stored in the client end. So during the next interaction, the client will interact with the server using the cookie, right? So using, what is this cookie? It is nothing but it is a small piece of information which will be stored in the client end, right? See here, I'll just implement this particular concept using the program. See, I'll use the NetBeans editor for this. See, I'll take NetBeans editor. See, I'll create one project here by the name new project, Java web, web application, next, next. I'll select this Java EE5, next, finish. So here one web application will be created, right? So the name of the web application, this is a web application one, okay? Now here, when I explore this, so you have this two folders, one web pages and we have the source packages. So in the web pages, I'll create one index.html page. See? index.html, okay? So, and I'll take one more page called set info. Set info. This is one more page I'm going to take. So in web pages, you have two pages now, one index.html. See, one more page, I'll see here. And we have one more page, setinfo.html, right? So this page I'm going to delete here, JSP page. So, and I'll set this index.html as a welcome page. how to set. I'll go to the configuration file and set this here in the welcome file list, right? This is one XML tag. So here I'll set this index.html. So here I'll begin to write the code, right? So just to save the time, I'll just copy the code and I'll paste it. So here I am going to take the two links. Okay. So what are the two links I'm going to take? One is the new visitor and this is the existing visitor. Okay. Now here I am going to take this new visitor as setInfo.html, right? And existing user visitor is read cookie. So these are the two links I'm going to create here. See what happens here. See, I'll create two cookies. That is, I'll take two servlet pages, right? New, how to create a servlet? New servlet here. I'll take one class name, add cookie one, right? Just class name. I'll put it in this package A, B, C, D, some package name. This is one cookie, right? I'll click on finish. So here one cookie will be added here. Next, I'll right click on this packages, new, one more servlet, I'll add it here. I'll name this as read cookie, right? Next, click finish, right? Now here you see, so far I have created index.html, two links are there in that. I have setInfo.html, right? Here, what I am going to create, I am going to create the user preferences, right? See here, just to save the time, I'll just copy and paste the code. See here, what did I do it here? I have taken the three user preferences, that is first name, last name and email ID and one submit button, right? And I have taken one parent tag, that is the legend tag I have taken, right? See here, simple here, three text boxes. How do I recognize this text box? With the name N1, text box 2, name N2, email ID, name N3. These are the user preferences, okay? So here in the add cookie, what happens here? I'll write the code here. So I'll delete unwanted code here. See here. Here. So here, I'll retrieve these three parameters. See, I have this setInfo now. That is, I'll retrieve all these three parameters in the add cookie. I'll write the code for this. I'll just copy and paste the code. See here. See, so here, what did I do here? Just I'm getting that error. I'm not. See, I can fix this. See, I have to import one package, right? So what is this? See, this cookie is a class that is there in this package. So just I'll fix this imports. That is javax servlet.http.cookie. the cookie class is there within the package called HTTP. Then I'll click OK here. See here. Now, what did I do here? Here, I have used this. See. Here I have these three things. See these three. See what is happening here? I have accepted the request here in index.html. See, these are the three parameters here. See, in setInfo.html, I have three parameters. That is first name, last name, email ID. In add cookie, right? I am going to accept these parameters N1, N2, N3. So I'll use this get parameter to accept get parameter N1, get parameter N2, get parameter N3, right? So after that, here I am going to create a cookie. Right, here you just see cookies I'm going to create. Cookie C1, new cookie. Here, this is the class, C1 is an object. So here, this is a parameterized constructor. It will accept the information in the form of name and value. It will, and this name and value information will be stored in this cookie C1. This name and value information will be stored in the cookie C2. So this information will be stored in the C3. Next, what happens? I am going to set the time for these three cookies. That is 60 by 60. That is what happens? 60 by 60, 3600 second, 3600 into 24. That is 1 day. So I'm going to set the time for this cookie C1 for 1 year. For second cookie, 1 year. So 1 year time interval I'll set for this cookies, right? Then I'll add the cookie in the response object. C1, C2, C3, right? Now all the three cookies will be stored in the client. That is in the web browser it will be stored. Now, I am going to retrieve this cookie. I'm going to retrieve this cookie in this particular servlet, read.cookie.java. Read.cookie.java. In this servlet, I have to retrieve. So what I'm going to do it here, I'll create one link. I'm going to create one link to this particular What link? Link to this particular servlet. See, in the add cookie 1.java, I'm going to create one link, right? Link to this read cookie using this href, right? Read cookie. What happens here? Read cookie. So when I click this link, the control will be transferred to this particular servlet. So here also in this particular servlet, you please delete unwanted lines here. To retrieve the cookie, you have to write one part of the code here. See here. Here, I require this code. I'll fix the imports here. See, here what I'm going to do, using this request, I'll retrieve all the cookies. Right? I'll retrieve all the cookies from the client. And I'll store it in this object called CK. then I'll use this for loop. I'll use this for loop, right, to retrieve all these cookies. See, for example, so when I run this loop for the first time, what happens? CK zero, I value will be zero. CK zero dot get name. You're going to get the name of the cookie here, and CK I, that is zero dot get value. What does it will do? It will. These are the two methods here: get name and get value. So during the first run, it will get the name of name and the value of first cookie C1. During the second run, it will get the name and value of the second cookie. During the third run, it will get the name and value of the third cookie. Okay. So now, for formatting code, I'll add it here. See now. I think one brace is missing here. Yeah, my cookie program is ready. When I run this program, right? So you'll get this screen. Okay, so this is for new visitor. This is for old visitor. Okay. Next, when I click here, okay, it will ask me to enter the details here, like Sunil. I'll enter first name and last name. Okay, I'll click the submit button. Okay, the data will be submitted to the server, right? Then one cookie will be created in the servlet, right? So the form data will be sent where? It will be sent to add cookie. Right, there you are creating one servlet. Right, sorry, there you are going to create the cookies for user preferences. So what are the user preferences there? First name, last name, and email ID. For these three preferences, I'll create the three cookies. Then I'll create a link for this second servlet to retrieve the cookie. See here, if I want to retrieve those cookies, I'll click on this. So I'll be able to retrieve this cookie, first name, last name, and email. Right. Now the question is that where the cookies will be stored? The cookies will be stored in the client end, right? So I'll just show you that where the cookies will be stored. So you have to click on the settings here in the Chrome browser. Here in the search, you give cookie, right? Cookie, right? You click on the site setting, right? Then here you have cookies and site data. No, you click on this, right? Here you see, you click on this, see all the cookies and site data. Just you type here localhost. Localhost. See here. When I click on this localhost, here you see how many cookies we have. Email, right? Email. Here, you just see. See Sunil, I created this one cookie. Here, sunil@gmail.com. Expiry time 1 year I gave. See here, created today. I have created here Sunil, April 26, 2020. It will expire after 1 year.